Hello friends, welcome to another video of Engineering Minutes. If you are new, then please visit our channel and see our past videos. So, we know that when we are heating the water in vessel, it starts converting into its gaseous form at particular temperature, say about 100 degrees Celsius in day-to-day condition. This temperature is known as boiling point temperature, and the process is known as boiling. Then what is the difference between evaporation and the boiling? So let's start our video with microscopic visualization of liquid substance. Molecules of any liquid are attracted with each other with some force. This force is known as intermolecular force. In order to leave molecules from liquid substance, it must overcome from this force. In both the processes, molecule must be separated from liquid substance. So it requires energy to overcome this force, and this energy is available via heat. Let's see molecules that have enough energy to leave the liquid substance. So we require energy distribution. Area under this curve represents number of molecules, and this line represents the velocity barrier. It means such a velocity will be required to overcome the intermolecular force, because velocity has direct relation to the energy. So this much amount of molecules have enough energy to overcome the intermolecular force. Now, when the temperature increases, this curve becomes flatter and flatter, and that is more number of molecules will be available to leave the liquid substance. Now let's take same vessel, but this time cover it with lid, so there is room for gas enough. Molecules on the liquid gas interface will have some energy which is received via heat, and these molecules will start leaving the liquid and convert into vapor phase. Because of random motion and collision, they exert a force on the liquid gas interface, on the sidewalls of the container, and on the lid. And this create pressure, which is known as vapor pressure. The phenomena of molecules leaving liquid substance via this process is known as evaporation. Now, if we somehow remove this lid, its absence is fulfilled by atmosphere. So, more or less, we can say that higher the intermolecular force means higher the energy required to leave molecules from liquid substance. It means lower number of molecules will be available, so lower vapor pressure. So this explains evaporation. But what is boiling? If vapor pressure and atmospheric pressure become same, then this temperature becomes boiling point. Now again, take same example. We are heating vessel with help of some power source, and lower side of water means lower molecules will get heat first, so they convert into vapor form, and there is a pressure of bubble. This bubble is surrounded by many liquid molecules, which exerts pressure on this vapor bubble. But with the help of vapor pressure, this bubble comes on the liquid gas interface and collapses. And this phenomena is known as boiling. So what we learned today? Difference between evaporation and boiling. Evaporation can occur at any pressure, and it occurs only on liquid gas interface, whereas its boiling can occur only on boiling point, which can be balanced by vapor pressure or atmospheric pressure. If vapor pressure is high, then we should increase atmospheric pressure, or if atmospheric pressure is low, then we should decrease vapor pressure. So I hope you understand our topic. And if you like this video, then share this video and like it. If you really like this video, then don't forget to subscribe our channel. Press the bell icon so you can get regular updates.
You can like our Facebook page where we put everyday new fact. You can also contact via Gmail account. You can also follow our Instagram page on which we put fact every day.